Deville, you're checking out Thisis50.com. I've been producing my whole life. I mean, you know, I've been around it, been around studios, and you know, my pops pretty much put it in the forefront for me to always have it. He didn't really have a regular job, you know, until he was, you know, making music himself. He had a career, so what he taught me is what he pretty much knew. I had, like, you know, keyboards, and it would get bigger and bigger each year. And I kept producing. I kept meeting people, networking, and keeping stuff fresh, relevant, you know. And I always had a CD, always gave somebody a CD at a car show, whatever the case was, a performance. Like, I always made sure somebody knew what I was doing. And my pops was, like, a spokesman, too. Like, he made sure people knew that I was producing. So it's cool, man. We get a minute, man. It's with the endless slang. I'm so high, I make the summer feel like it's winter, man. Ain't no beginner, man. They see me swinging chains. Hollywood switching lanes a minute to win it, man. I got to see him do everything, you know, back then, 10 years ago, the industry was different. So money was big and, you know, cars and everything was on a major level. So, you know, now you see everything is done and saturated to where, like, you know, anyone can just be a artist, and which is cool. You know, you get different sounds and different things like that, but at the time, just seeing him do that major stuff, traveling and being gone for months, it was dope, you know, and he would definitely come back and bring all that music to me and show me things and put me up on game. Like, you know, my history of music is crazy, just from classic rock to hip-hop and R&B and, I mean, funk records. It's like no stop to what I have instilled inside of me. It's crazy. The biggest placement that I had was for Snoop, that Life of the Party record that I did for him a couple years back on the last album, Ego Trippin'. And you know, a lot of people were like, who did this record? I did like four on that album. And Snoop is pretty much the one who gave me the, you know, who gave me the push and solidified me in the rap game with all the everyone in it. So, you know, I definitely owe Snoop a lot. We're still working, we're still doing a lot of songs, and now we got the I Wanna Rock out, which is, you know, one of the biggest hip-hop records out right now, and it's definitely cool to see where that's going, you know. And I'm from LA, now we're in New York, and it's like becoming a natural thing for me to be here and, you know, make moves. Fresh out, slip out, everybody rap out, Deville, he ill, hit it, then I check out, bet out, spend a couple mil like Glad Al, splash on new fits, splash till I black out. Yeah, I rap, you know, I'm a part of Get Busy Committee, it's like a rap group. Like, I also, you know, get to showcase different things in a song, right? You know, just to see where that's going too. Like, a lot of people are respecting that I already have my own hustle as an artist and a producer. That people, you know, are very starting to know me as an artist now, so. I'm just, you know, working from the ground up. A lot of people know that my pops, you know, had me in the game for a minute. So I was rapping before I was producing. So it's like, you know, everything kind of goes hand in hand. I'm working with Clips and, you know, working with Jamie Foxx. I got a few other people. So I'm just trying to branch out and keep, you know, keep the cycle going. It's, you know, it's still early at it's early stage of my career. So hopefully, you know, see where it goes. It's going to be good. Shout out to the Get Busy Committee, Uzi Does It, in stores now. You know, shout out to Tony G, G-Unit, thank you for having us. And, you know, just keep on pushing. If you're serious about it, get a team, get your stuff out there, and don't stop. That's it. Don't listen to nobody. Because you only know if you're really worth what you say you are. So just keep it pushing. Slip out, everybody rap out, Deville.